Welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. Today we're going to be reviewing wedge anchors, so let's get started. Zinc plated wedge anchors are used in interior applications and can be used on exterior applications. Hot dip galvanized wedge anchors are used for exterior applications in fresh water, such as rainwater, bay water, anything where you are using it in a non-salt water application. 304 stainless is also used in fresh water. This will give you long-lasting, non-corrosive application. So you would use stainless steel in an application where you do not want to see any rust over a period of time or any surface corrosion. 316. 316 stainless is marked as 316. You'll find it marked on the nut, 316 stainless. You'll find it on the washer marked as 316 stainless. And you'll see a marking on the bottom of a 316 stainless wedge anchor. These wedge anchors can be used in saltwater applications such as docks, decks, anywhere you have, or a boardwalk, anywhere you have a application where you're using saltwater. Okay, so we're going to prepare to install this half inch wedge anchor. We're going to take the nut off and the washer. We're going to use this blue tape as a marker to prevent from drilling through the concrete. I'm drilling into 8 inches of concrete here, so I have no worries. This is a 2¾-inch wedge anchor, so I have no worries about drilling through the concrete. You never want to drill through the concrete so the bottom of the wedge anchor goes through the concrete. You always want to make sure you have enough thickness in concrete for the correct length of wedge anchor. You want to have at least 1 inch sticking out of the top of the concrete when you finish. So I'm going to take the wedge anchor and just put it up here and go approximately 1 inch below, and then I'm going to put the tape where I want to stop from drilling, stop the drill from continuing to drill it through the concrete. If you drill the hole too deep, it's not really going to hurt it. If you were a little further, let's say another half inch, you just don't bang the wedge anchor too far down, because once you push it down, you will not, this piece down here creates the wedge. Once you put the wedge anchor into the hole and you pull up on it, it then wedges into the concrete, preventing you from pulling the anchor out. At that point, you would have to use a sawzall and cut it off to make it even with the concrete, and then fill the hole, push it down and fill the hole if you, you know, want to close up the hole. So now we're prepared and ready to drill a hole in the concrete and install the wedge anchor. You just want to tighten it to where it snugs up very tight. There you go. It is now, that post base is now installed. Put the cover over it. Put your post in. Your deck is ready to go in place. There you go. We reviewed the proper installation for a wedge anchor along with the proper materials to be used for your application. Visit us at albanycountyfasteners.com for 50,000 SKUs ready to ship right off the rack. Please comment, subscribe, and like us. Look forward to seeing you at our next video.